Team started out this season with singular goals to make it to the NCAA tournament. Nick, that business has been taken care of. Now it's time for the madness to begin in today's game between the UCLA Bruins and the Penn State Nittany Lions.
Both teams need to forget about the wild crowd here and play basketball.
The Nittany Lions could be in for a tough one tonight, Dick. What do they have to do if they want to have a chance to win tonight?
Well, partner, here's what I see as the key to the game. First, the point guard has to take control of the game, and he has to dictate the tempo and the pace. Secondly, set good interior screens to free up your big men on the block. Look to the inside first. Finally, it's imperative that you win the battle of the boards.
I think you're dead on, Mr. Vitale. Let's see what happens. Let's get this one started. Number five receives the pass. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
He gets the board. Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. From the baseline, they'll bring it out on top. From the top of the circle, number 20 for three. Down low, there's a drop step, and oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step, very slow.
Defense all over him here.
The defender is still applying great ball pressure, Brad.
Gave it up.
Great anticipation defensively. This should be an easy bucket here, Mr. Nestler.
For two, perfectly executed. Looking for a good shot.
Ooh, look at a shot block. We got some contact. Nice hops.
Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Leaning in, trying to draw contact. Buried it. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen when you bring the ball down to the inside.
Pump fakes. He goes with a baby hook.
That's a great shot. I don't understand why it's not utilized more often. It's so impossible to block that shot.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nestler. We got a good one going.
That's a breakdown. That'll drive a coach bananas. Help you to lose your hair.
They look to get it to the inside. On the dribble, gives it up. The skip pass is picked off. Problem with that when you front, if you don't get some backside help, you're in trouble.
Well, you got to get help because you got to see ball, man. That's essential when you play on there and you front it.
Showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Entry pass in the paint.
Great play to take that to the basket.
On the inside for the bucket, perfectly executed. Gave it up. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
Number 33 receives the ball. He pulls the trigger off the rim and no good. It in. Number 42 is feeling good.
He may be in the zone right now, Brad.
Dick, he really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle and they also have the good entry from the wing.
Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. He up fakes. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works. Trying to go inside.
Kicks it out. The point guard handles the feed. 10 on the shot clock. No.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Penn is one of the premier schools in the Ivy League. Numerous league championships.
Hey, it usually comes down to them and Princeton. However, Penn was a dominant force for most of the 70s.
Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Number three handles the pass. Another turnover.
And we're not talking apple turnovers either.
Got the shot if he wants it. Way off target. Trying to feed inside. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Lost some ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. Number 23 fakes the shot. Defensively down on the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Misses the first. He misses the second shot. They take it off the defensive glass.
Then they've got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
He was looking for the call, and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats it to the spot.
Looking for a screen on top and got it. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. The Nittany Lions still have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here.
Poor job offensively. I'm coaching, he's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball to the deck, where's he going?
On the outside. Trying to draw the foul.
Nice job to create the angle using the glass.
On the dribble, gives it up. There's a bad pass right to the defender. There's a high percentage shot.
Wow, what hops, baby, what hops.
They'll work it around the arc. Let's watch the defense down on the low block.
See, first initially he wants a three-quarter. Then he plays him where he gets good post position, so he's able to get the ball. A good rebound position, a good block out. And that's essential in the post. A lot of guys don't realize part of post play is ultimately a block out and get good rebound position.
And in and out. Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Jumps in.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say? Layup, son. I'm telling you, Brad, you can have a field day against these guys. Why don't you put a uniform on?
Nobody within 10 feet of an easy basket again.
I mean, unbelievable. It's blowout city.
Up and inside.
He makes a nice shot fake. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
Fakes the shot. And now they'll bring it up. Number two steals the ball. Three, This young guy is a crowd favorite, Dick.
He means so much to the program. He's a consistent performer and always competes at a high level. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Penn State are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby.
Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
Trying to draw some contact. He knocks down another bucket. Dude.
This kid's got skills, Brad.
Gave it up.
Coach looks on. Focused. A lot of intensity. A lot of emotion.
Shot clock is dead. On the dribble. Gives it up. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job front of him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity. And it really converts an offensive transition.
At the half, the Nittany Lions are up by four. Let's take a look back and watch the play of the half. UCLA has a lot more turnovers than I'm used to seeing them have in a first half, Dick.
I must admit it, I'm still trying to figure out their game plan. Do they think they can win without any offensive possessions? It would take a miracle for that to happen.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as you can imagine, both coaches were very intense as I met with them at halftime. They said at this point, it all comes down to playing their game, having fun, and enjoying the moment. Guys?
All right, thanks, Aaron. He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D. Nice fake.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
In and out.
Pressure in the basketball. He may be in trouble here, Brad.
And up off the rim and no good. Both teams are looking to get something going here. The crowd really admires this young man.
The people here really appreciate what he brings to the table.
Picks off the lazy pass. Looking for a good shot. Here he comes defensively on him on the low block.
I tell you, three-quarter position, trying to deny, but then he does a great job of post position and spreading his body and getting the ball.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Watch here.
Fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Rims out. Dick, you know, we always like comparing positions and specific matchups. What are your thoughts about the backcourt matchup so far?
Hey, Brad, sometimes comparisons can be misleading. If your backcourt is weaker, then you just hope to contain your opponent's guards. Keep them in check. If you have strong backcourt play, you must attack and exploit any mismatches.
He makes his second shot. pushes it up, turns it over. The power forward takes the feed. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot. Look at speed. I tell you, man, there's nothing like having athleticism and quickness.
The point guard with the ball.
Look at that spacing.
He lets it go. Off the rim and no good. The power forward gets the ball. That spin move not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Here's a double team. He shoots from right of the circle. Way off target. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting him.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in man.
Offense gets it back after that ball was knocked loose.
Hey, Brad, it's embarrassing to get scored on like that.
Takes away the pass. The point guard takes the pass. Goes up for two.
Watch this again.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Trying to come up with a steal, and they do. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Number two comes up with it. Tries for two. Can't get the
shot. Ooh, look at a shot block, but he got some contact. Nice hops.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Moving it around the perimeter.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards up there.
Yeah, that helps. 10 on the shot clock. Here's another look, Dick. Pushes it up. For two. Can't get the shot to drop. Looking for a good shot. The shot from the baseline. Off the rim and no good. For the bucket. Doesn't go. Goes up for two. And he missed. Gave it up. Time to pick up the defense here now. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
He's making just terrible choices shooting the ball.
He's got to settle down, man. Settle that cat down.
Picked off. Dick, the tournament seems like it's so tight. These two teams have showed that they belong. They played great in the first half, and now it's going to come down to the wire, it looks like.
Well, I really believe that, too. I agree with you, Brad. I think the last few possessions are going to dictate who moves on, survives, advances, and who goes home.
It. The defensively doing a great job down there, and he's winning that battle, Dick.
I think it's very essential that you establish post position by moving that offensive player out, and that's how he's winning that battle.
A severe offensive drop for them right now, Dick.
And it doesn't seem to be turning around as of yet, Brad. Up and inside.
Controlling the ball. The small forward gets the pass. Almost lost the basketball. Tries one from three-point land. 10 seconds to put it up. Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Jumped in front to take it away. On the outside, picks off the pass. And a momentary look from three-point land.
Pushing that basketball.
Takes it off him. They're off into transition. UCLA have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
There's a double team waiting there. Working it around the perimeter. They work it back to the outside. He unloads. Buried it. That brings the lead to 8 points, Dick.
But 8 points doesn't secure a win at this point, Brad.
He takes the three. It won't fall. Work it around the arc. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
There they come with a double team to stop it. Taken away. The Bruins have a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
For two. Off the rim and no good. Well, now it's just a matter, Dick, isn't it, of clock management here? Continue to foul to stop the clock.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
And yet another foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again. Clock stop with a foul. How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points, they add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
He hits the second shot. We've got a timeout on the floor. Surprise the opposition with a little change here, Dick.
That might not be a bad idea.
Dick, is 10 points safe at this point?
Are you kidding me? 10 scratches wouldn't be safe with half of this time left.
He's not letting the game come to him at all.
Yeah, Brad, he's trying too hard to build a one-man show. He's taking the game away from his other teammates. Come on, man, get with the team. Get in the flow.
The ball goes out of play. Wow, Dick, let's check out that State Farm drive of the game.
Hey, what a great move, Brad. He was able to find an opening and finish at the basket. That's a great finish. Highlight material, baby.
Tries to get the D to bite. He goes with a jump hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. He puts it in with contact and all.
What does that mean? Experts is the evidence for the stretch of lifespan of the lifespan of any disease.
Screener gets the worst of that screen with the elbow. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that, and it's heartbreak for the other club, but, you know, you got to win it. Keep on going to get that final Monday night game.
Well, I tell you, win this game, Brad, and look at it, analyze it, because they really had all the right people shoot the ball at the right moment. They did a terrific job offensively.
The Nittany Lions came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team, because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during the regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well, as now they shifted the gear for that second-round matchup.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.
Flattening the curve, hopefully never.